people are saying, well, you're never gay in the first place, or you still are gay and closeted. And so effectively, it comes down to dismissing your lived experience and framing someone's identity in their own way, which is a total hypocrisy on an LGBT individual or their allies. It's hypocrisy on their standpoint by not letting us identify and testify to who we are and what our ideal selves are and who our authentic selves are. As a Christian, I believe that it's the darkness, the principalities that we're warring against, that doesn't want us to exist, because our existence calls into question their presuppositions about what it means to be gay, as in an ontological statement. Mm-hmm. You know, the foreign gay myth said $500 million of marketing pumped into it, even though it's not true. And sexual right. orientation, as the world defines it, is fluid, and change is possible. But we exist. Our existence, the ex-gay script, as some people are critical of us, there are some people that go back to the gay lifestyle that are ex-gays, right? And I have a testimony of being an ex-gay. So I'll see your ex-gay in Trumpia one, because I was an ex-gay. I came out of homosexuality, tried to live as a straight individual, but I was still same-sex attracted. And then I went back to homosexuality. And then God did a final work to bring me back. But it comes down to, we exist because the power of Jesus, the grace of Christ to transform the heart and mind, is a very real thing. And so he's transformed my heart, that heart of stone, and the lies that I believed and the counterfeit that I accepted as a gay Christian. He set me free of that and revealed to me what it is in my brotherly love with my best friend that I named my son after. You know, to have a brother come alongside of me and demonstrate to me what phileo is, brotherly love, to really live in agape love, and to have a wife that supports me and loves me and affirms me as a man. Like, we exist, and they can't deny the experience that we've gone through and the truth and the testimony of Jesus in our lives.